I think it's I-95 there a couple times in South Florida, and the fog got so thick, guy pulled off the road, and that yet people were still doing 60 and 70 passes. Go ahead.
Yeah, I've been in those conditions, and you're right. You don't, when I get in those conditions, and I can't see, you know, you put your headlights on, all your headlights do is it diminish your visibility because you get the reflection of the headlights off the fog. So fog lights to me don't work. They might work better at night, but during the day, they're useless. I have been conditioned like that where the fog is so thick. I had to look out my front window. My window, because the fog is pressing up the windshield, and I looked out the side window, and I couldn't see anything in front of me, so I'm poking along trying to find the edge of the road, and I drive off a cliff, and I finally got, when I got to the edge of the road, I rolled up, and there was a car. I'd have run into the back of it, and he was stopped. And he was doing the same thing I was. He was trying to feel his way off the road. It was so bad.
Yeah, we have Peter down here is another real trick. We got I-25, which runs north and south. And it seems like 60% of the vehicles that are wrecked on I-25 during the winter are four-wheel drive vehicles. People who own them that don't have a clue, they think that because they've got four-wheel drive that they can stop anywhere. Well, they try to stop and it becomes a four-wheel slide.
Yeah, I know what you mean. W6BBA for ID. Yeah, yes. I've been there. Especially if you get on black ice. Up in Texas, they had a blizzard up there, and I was driving through Amarillo, Texas. And then just on the other side of Amarillo, I took a shortcut, which takes me up to Dumas and another place. I come down just south of Colorado Springs, Raton. I think I come out in Raton. And that little road going up there through the prairie and everything else and going through those little towns, I got out in the prairie, and the snow was just a whiteout blowing across the road. I couldn't even see the road, but it was slippery, I know that. And all I could tell where the road was the fence post. There was nobody else out there, so I went right straight down the middle of what I thought was the road, and I made equidistant between the fence posts. The only way I could tell the road was there.
And CC0NJ for ID. Yeah, I know exactly what you mean. We get that heavy winds and snow, and it's a whiteout is kind of scary. I've been in a couple of them up in Alaska, and it's just not worth the hassle. Dale, I take you for a few ACZ0NJ. You still there, Dale?
We got a real nice sunny day today. I guess it's probably about 75 degrees. Beautiful day. And I'm going to do a little antenna work here. I cranked my quad down. Oh, I have, did I tell you that I talked to France with my quad?
No, that doesn't seem like it'd be a big problem. Last weekend I had Google down there in Australia a couple times on 21 meters. It's pretty good. The only problem is we've got a 400 watt radio. It's broken. We haven't had chance to get the 60 up. So he's only running about 100 watts. That makes hearing quite difficult. I was running about 1400, and you could hear me with no problem. Go ahead.
Yeah, Roger. Well, there was an interesting thing with this France contact. He was in southern France, and it was F5RAG was his call, I'm pretty sure. Anyway, I heard him. I didn't have any amplifiers on or anything like that. And I 746 Pro was sitting here, but I was doing some tuning with it, and I was using the Pro as a driver, of course. And I had turned the RF gain on the Pro all the way down to zero. I mean, totally down. And when you do that, it only puts out about 1 or 2 watts. Well, I had to turn all the way down. And this guy was calling CQ, and I heard him. He was at 9 plus. Nice signal. So I said, well, I'll say hello. So I called him. So when I was calling him, I looked at my meter on the screen here. No power output whatsoever. It was just a blank screen. And I called him, and he came right back to me. And I'm looking, I'm saying, what? Something wrong with this picture. You know, I'm talking, but I don't see any output, no indication on the meters or nothing. And I realized that I had that thing turned all the way down. He heard me and came right back to me, said I was at S4 and I was only running about 2 watts.
Now that's the condition. You certainly don't hear that much anymore. Dale, let's see the conditions of things that you have. What is the weather like there? Okay, 1 inch of rain. Yeah, that's pretty good rainfall. They're saying that we might get a little bit of rain this afternoon. We just have to see on that. There's a slight chance of rain. But it seems like winter has still got a bit of a grip on us because tomorrow is supposed to be cooler than what it is today. So it'd be nice when we get some warm weather finally.
This is Jim. 64 is 86 KG, this is ACURJ with 56 DDA. No, he's still not there. Must have had to go out for something. It's unusual. Did you get your tower laid down and fixed yet, Bob?
Oh, yes, I did. The tower's laid down. My safety latch is installed. It works beautifully. I can crank up to about 48, almost 50 feet, about 48 feet. I was cranked all the way up, but I didn't leave yesterday because we had 70 knot wind, tornado warning. All kinds of stuff. We had a lot of stuff come rolling through here yesterday. Lots of rain and lots of lots of wind and tornadoes. Tornadoes all over the place. So they were saying 70 knot winds. Gusts well over 70 knots. So I cranked everything down. I haven't cranked everything up. The tower's up, I've just sampled down. I'm only at about 30, 35 feet with the antennas and the quad. I'll crank them back up here pretty soon. The gear ratio is so high, it takes me forever to do that. So I modified my winch and I put a drill on it. I've got a big heavy drill. And so I put a drill on it. The shaft fits my drill, the variable holder on the drill, just perfectly. So I put the drill on there, pitch up on it, pull the trigger, and away I go. But I haven't cranked it up today. But other than that,
We had we must have had 3 or 4 inches of rain down here. We get lots of rain, and it's usually in multiple inches. But other than that, everything seems to be fine. We had no suffered no damage or anything like that. Go ahead.
Oh, that's good. You guys have been getting a lot of wind this year, haven't you, compared to previous years?
Oh, yeah. We've had some hellacious storms go through here. I knock on wood, I consider myself lucky because the wind that we're doing, a majority of this stuff, it comes up from the Gulf, and it flows kind of in a northeasterly direction, and flows up through Texas, Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, and we're very, very, I consider ourselves lucky. We're far enough north off the coast here in Crestview, but a lot of this stuff goes north of us. It passes us. It goes up north of us. We do get a few pieces of it, but now yesterday, the stuff was not going north. It was going east, and all the real, real heavy, heavy crap stayed in the Gulf. It didn't come ashore. We were lucky because it was some really bad stuff happening. The seas on the Gulf were up to 8 to 10 feet, and that's right in the Gulf hitting the shore. Man, I mean, we saw some heavy stuff, but that stuff was moving at almost 40 to 50 miles an hour. It blew through us like you wouldn't believe. And we had tornado warnings and watches in my area here, but only for about 30, 35 minutes, and then wham, this stuff just blew right on through. So we got some rain, but other than that, we were in good shape. Go ahead.
Okay, well, this just popped in. Dale, what Bob was talking about was they've had a lot of high winds this year, but the storms, they had one where they had 70 knot winds here recently, plus tornado warnings and all sorts of things, but fortunately, no damage. He's had the, the antenna's been down partially, I guess, and the fortunate thing is that the storms are in and out quickly.
I've got her all set up. I've got the safety latch installed. It works great, and I just haven't had a chance to put the drill on it and crank her back up to full height again. But No, I'm using the 746 Pro this morning. Today. And I'm using my 76 Alpha. So usually I run about 500 watts. I'm actually running it closer to about 14, 1500 right now. Go ahead.
What was the question, Al?
Go ahead, Ken.
Yeah, what did he ask right at the end?
I didn't quite catch all that, Jim. But Bob, if you go to Fox News Network online, the very top article is about that fiery crash yesterday. And apparently the truck driver who caused the accident was 23-year-old Hispanic. They didn't say a whole lot about him, whether he was, they did. He is being held for several counts of, homicide, I guess, or death, well, related to the deaths in the accident. So it was really quite a mess. Go ahead. Yeah, it would. Of course, I'm withholding judgment because I don't know enough about it. But I certainly hope he's not illegal. Anyhow, I'm sure he's going to be seeing a lot of precious sunlight for the rest of the most of his life. But still, that doesn't bring back people that were lost. That's the very unfortunate part. The material, the cars, the trucks, the things you can replace, but the people you can't. That's going to be kind of tough. But hopefully we'll get more information out of it. I can imagine that the owner of the trucking company that owns the rig, they're probably going to be on the hook for multi-millions of dollars here. Go ahead.
My wife a few years ago got in an accident and she called me and told me. And I said, are you okay? She said, yeah, but the car is total. I said, I don't give a damn about the car. I can replace that, but I can't replace you. And that's the name of the game. You can't replace life. But you and life is not.
Yes, unfortunately. Jim, you had something? Go ahead.
I saw something on the news last night. Are you speaking about the truck that ran into a house over?
No, it was a truck that ran into about 24 other vehicles on I-70 just west of Denver, in Lakewood area. The traffic was, it was around 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and that's when things really slowed down on I-70 around Denver. And apparently there were 4 deaths and at least 24 vehicles involved.
Coming home from work early evening, late afternoon time frame, and her row of traffic went through an intersection, and the traffic all stopped on the other side of the street. She was the
on the west side of the state is Grand Junction.
Yeah, okay. That's where the two rivers come together, two railroads or something. So country is kind of flattened out there, but it's kind of pretty country, rather.
Okay, are you talking Dale? We don't want to leave Dale or Elf out. Go ahead.
Yeah, I hear Dale.
Okay, Elf, are you still in there? Quite the action. It's very unfortunate. Apparently, one of the trucks, and I'm not sure which one it was a had a load of lumber on it. And of course, you mix lumber, flame, and diesel fuel, and you can get one heck of a fire.
Yesterday, so I'm more than three quarters of a century old now. I know that doesn't mean much to you, Jim. I'm a kid compared to you. You're my dad. But my dad lived to be 76. He passed at 76. So I've hit a milestone here. I'm as old as my father was. But now the big object is to see if I can live just a little bit longer than he did. So one of the things you want to do is you want your children to usually outlive you. So hopefully maybe I'll be around for a little longer to see how Trump fares in 2020 and what this country's going to look like by 2024. It's going to be an unbelievable country the way things are going. W6DVA, go ahead and get it.